The surgical options that are offered to patients with bicuspid aortic valve are diverse, and they range from valve repair with or without a valve-sparing aortic root replacement to a Ross procedure, which is valve replacement with a pulmonary autograft, to valve replacement with a mechanical prosthesis, to valve replacement with a biologic valve. Bicuspid aortic valve can cause two different types of valvular dysfunction, aortic stenosis or aortic regurgitation. In a very broad terms, aortic stenosis can be treated with transcatheter aortic valve implantation or replacement. For patients with bicuspid aortic valve plus aortic regurgitation, these patients are best treated with surgery, either valve repair with or without aortic aneurysm replacement. Transcatheter aortic valve replacement isn't the only minimally invasive option for patients with bicuspid aortic valve and aortic stenosis. Minimally invasive cardiac surgery is also an excellent option for these patients. This is a procedure where a keyhole incision is opened, typically between the ribs, and full open heart surgery can be performed, so therefore either a mechanical valve or a biologic valve can be used. This is an excellent option for patients who have risk factors for transcatheter aortic valve implantation. Oftentimes, patients with a bicuspid aortic valve also have a concomitant aortic aneurysm. In those cases, an aortic root replacement is also indicated. That procedure is called a valve-sparing aortic root replacement, and at the same time, we could do a bicuspid aortic valve repair. In those patients where bicuspid aortic valve repair is not a good option, then those patients would get a complete aortic root replacement with a composite valve graft, and that is a valve mounted on a Dacron graft. And these are excellent options for patients with bicuspid aortic valve, aortic regurgitation with or without aortic aneurysm. And we're particularly worried about aortic aneurysms because they can cause aortic dissection or aortic rupture, both of which are aortic emergencies. Now, those risks increase as the aortic aneurysm size increases, so it behooves us to replace these aneurysms before they get too big. Typically, we use a size threshold of 5.0 centimeters for prophylactic aortic root replacement or ascending aortic root replacements. We know that some patients will have dissections below that threshold number. That's where 4D MRI comes into place. Advanced imaging options allows us to identify patients who are potentially at higher risk for aortic dissection and offer them a timely surgery before an aortic catastrophe happens. There's a very select group of patients with bicuspid aortic valve and aortic stenosis who may benefit from a procedure called the Ross procedure, which is replacement of the aortic valve with a patient's own pulmonary valve. We reserve this option for very young patients like less than 50 years old with bicuspid aortic valve and aortic stenosis.